Hi guys! So, as I had promised, I'm doing workout videos to help kill the boredom of the quarantine, also build my clientele. So I'm gonna be doing little workouts every day to kill the boredom, as I said, and get a workout in. And I know that I got a lot of response from when I had asked who would be interested in it. And so I'm actually excited to be doing this. I'm going to be working from my iPad as well. So I'm just trying to get everything set up. I will be playing music in the background. So that way we will have some energy. My neighbor is playing loud music too. So we might get some interference with that, have extra music. From what my Crunch group fitness trainer had told me, that Crunch is for beginners to badass. Not everyone is gonna be a badass at first, but we're gonna get there. It has been exciting to be working for a gym and finally put what I love to do to good use. So today we're gonna do something beginner. I'm a little out of shape and I don't want to do anything too hard quite yet. So we're just gonna do a basic ab and butt workout today. So we're gonna work on our core. So let me just get everything set up and then we'll start. I just gotta download it. Also, if you have an activity, Fitbit, Apple Watch, Samsung Watch, to track your activity, go ahead, we can use that as well. So we're gonna get started here. Alright, so right now we're going to be doing the hip lift march, which is going to work the hips, the core area. So I'm using my carpet in the living room, so we're going to do 50 seconds of this. And you're just gonna lay on your back and you're gonna lift your hips up. You wanna keep your legs, your bottom half of the leg straight. You're gonna extend it out and you're gonna do it, both legs. And make sure that your hips are straight. And you're gonna keep doing this. We're halfway there. This also helps with back posture, so you wanna keep your hips up and extend your legs out.
10 seconds to go.
We got 10 seconds left. Alright, so now we're going to do the fire hydrant. I'm going to move back a little bit so you guys can see me. We're going to be on our hands and knees. And I gotta set my fitness tracker. I am new to this, so please bear with me. I totally forgot to do this before. Alright. So now, you want your right arm out and your left leg.
Start with your hands under your shoulders and your knees under your hips.
And we're gonna just keep doing this. Make sure that you're balanced too. You don't wanna fall. And you wanna keep your back straight. We're almost there. This is just the beginner. We're gonna work our way up just so not to pull our muscles or injure ourselves. We got 10 seconds left. All right. So now we're gonna be doing runner touches. Let me turn this music up. I need to turn it up. All right, so this is what us runners do this helps the hips. So runner position, we're gonna be in runner position. We're gonna put our left leg back. We're gonna start straight. And we're gonna go like that.
On your right leg for 30 seconds.
And we're gonna
bring
your legs up.
Put your right foot into the ground for balance. And always come back up to the tall sprinter position. Reach to make yourself as long as you can.
This helps the hips too.
And your right leg back. Think of touching your right heel to the wall behind you.
Ah! Losing my balance here. Make sure you are balanced too.
Up next, All right. Runner touches on your left leg.
So, I was doing this both ways, so I'm just gonna skip the next one because this one right now, we're doing the left one. So, same thing. But we're just doing the left one.
Start in tall sprinter form. Next, stabilize your weight on your left.
I really need to stabilize myself because I'm awful at this. It's been a while. If you're starting to feel a little bit of sweat, that's good. That is the lactic acid in your body. You will feel a little bit of burning too if you're new to this. That is the lactic acid in your body getting used to this. So now we're gonna do star reaches. We're gonna squat down, arms up,
and reach for your toes.
And then reach for your
toes.
Back up, squat down, bend over. This helps the quads,
and reach your arms up overhead,
and it also gets the back hamstrings. This also does help your butt.
5 seconds to go.
So we're gonna hold it, and you want your legs, your knees to be a 90 degree angle. So now we're gonna do a plank. These are the absolute worst. You want your body and back to be complete straight. You're
going to
use your feet and arms to hold your weight. And we're just going to hold it.
Almost there.
5 seconds to go.
5 seconds left.
Get ready. Soft knee drives on your
So
left
now,
side
since this is a beginner, it has us moving around while doing the plank. We're not going to do that. We're just going to stay on our right side.
Bring your right elbow to your right thigh.
And you're going to lay on your side and have your elbow and feet hold you up.
Keep your neck nice and long and your whole body in a straight line.
And just hold it.
5 seconds left.
5 seconds left.
Now moving into side plank knee drives on your right side.
So now we're going to flip on the other side. My back is going to be turned to you. Elbow holding up.
Now,
having your arm on your hip also helps, or you can have it above your head. That also helps with the balance. I know that it can be hard sometimes.
Keep your hips up by pressing into your forearm and imagining a swing lifting your top hip up towards the ceiling. 5 seconds left.
5 seconds left.
Get ready.
Rolling
dumbbell halos for 60 seconds.
So now, we're not going to do this one because this you need a dumbbell and I don't have that. So we're going to do a lunge squat. So you're going to lunge forward and just go lightly up and down.
And using a full range of motion.
You don't want to take this too fast. You want to keep your balance as well. Keep your leg at a 90 degree angle when you go down for the squat.
There.
You're halfway there, she said. It also helps if you want to put your hands on your hips too. You can have them down.
You should feel this in your glutes, hamstrings, and quads.
You'll start to feel it burning in your legs. That is a lactic acid that is building up.
5 seconds left.
5 seconds left. And
split
next.
With your right leg
so now we're going to go to the other leg.
For 60 seconds. From a standing position, step forward with your right leg, hold the lunge position, and lower your back knee down to the ground. Then return to the starting position. Inhale on your way down, exhale on the way back up.
So you want to inhale on your way down, and exhale on your way back up.
There shouldn't be much weight on your back leg.
You want to inhale through the nose.
30 seconds to go.
Exhale through the mouth.
Focus on your form, not your speed.
You do want to go slow with this one too, because this is more about getting the power in your legs and your lower body.
5 seconds left. Get ready.
Okay.
Lateral lunges.
Now we're going to do lateral lunges.
Seconds.
And you're basically going side to side.
Step out and to the side. Reach your hips back like you're sitting into a chair. Push off the floor to return to your starting position.
We're almost there. I would use more of the space that I have, but fortunately I don't have a big camera and I'm not that technologically good at this right now.
Halfway there.
We're almost there. Hopefully by now you are starting to sweat a little bit.
The bigger you step to the side, the more you work those inner thighs. 5 seconds left.
All right.
Here we go. Cross back.
So, no wonder why. I had it on repeat, so that's why. So we're gonna take a little break to get some water and rehydrate. We're gonna take 1 minute for a water break.
Lunges.
And we're gonna do the side. You're gonna cross your left leg behind your right and squat down. Then right leg behind the left leg and squat down. Again, you want your knees to be at a 90 degree angle. Again, you can have your hands down like I did, or you can have them on your hips.
Halfway there.
Almost there.
Do your best to keep your shoulders and hips level.
Alright, now you want your hips and shoulders to be level. That also helps with the balancing.
5 seconds left.
We got 5 seconds left to go.
Time for
boat
to logo.
So now we're gonna do sort of a crunch. We're not gonna go down fully. We're gonna be like this and come back up. Then go back down, feet and back not touching the floor.
30 seconds.
And we're gonna do this for 30 seconds. And this is gonna work.
Holding your body at your hips.
The abs.
Your stay straight.
And the hips.
And together.
I have really bad balancing, so I might touch the ground.
You can modify the movement by holding on to the back of your legs or by putting your hands behind you.
It also will help to keep balance if you have your legs right here on the thighs. You want to keep your legs together as well.
10 seconds left. Try to get a few more.
10 seconds left.
Here we go. Plank alternating leg lifts.
All right. So now we're going to do the plank like we did before, but we're going to have a little bit of motion into it. We're going to get down like we have with our plank, and we're going to lift the left leg. We're going to hold it down. We're going to lift the right leg, and then lift. And we're going to keep rotating.
Seconds.
And we're going to do this for 60 seconds. Right leg down.
While holding a
left leg,
lift one leg up, hold
and down,
and let it down.
Right leg,
continue alternating legs, but keep
and
your
down.
Hips level and your lower back.
You want to keep your back and your butt straight. Left leg up and down. Right leg
left
up. Left leg up. Right leg up.
Get ready for it. Pendulum legs for 30 seconds.
So now we're going to do pendulum legs. We're going to be laying on our back.
We
this usually does work with two people. But right now I don't have extra help. We're gonna move our legs to the side together, not fully touching the floor. And you wanna keep your legs straight.
Halfway there.
You will feel the burn in this.
The goal is to keep your shoulder blades and your arms on the ground.
You wanna keep everything on the floor. Your back.
Alright. For 60 seconds.
So now, we're gonna do mountain climbers.
Start with your hands under your shoulders, knees an inch off the ground and under your hips.
We're gonna do the slow version of it. Left leg up, have your knee at the chest, then back down. Knee, right knee up at the chest, and down. And we're gonna do each leg.
Make precise movements.
You want your hands and shoulders straight.
Stay on the balls of your feet. Fingers
straight.
And you
want to stay, like she said, on the balls of your feet. You don't want to be on your flat part of the feet at all. Almost there.
Get ready.
Hard.
On your left leg for 30 seconds.
So now we're gonna just be laying on our back and have our right leg held up to the chest and we're gonna hold it there. For 30 seconds.
With your right knee pulled into your chest, lift up into a bridge position with your left hip. Hold at the top and then slowly lower down. Do this whole movement slowly and controlled.
So then, while being in that position, we're gonna lift our hips up and hold it.
5 seconds.
Down.
Now moving
back
into
up.
Hip lifts on your right leg.
Now we're gonna go to the left leg. Same thing as we did before. Up, down.
Now with your left knee into your chest. Bridge up and engage your glutes on the right side.
Back up.
At the top and then lower back down with control.
Back up and down. Back up and down.
Lower yourself down slowly and with control.
Back up.
And 5 seconds to go.
We got 5 seconds to go. Back up.
Time
and down.
Side plank leg lift.
Alright, so now we're going to be on our left side. We're going to be doing like the side plank, but now we're going to be lifting our leg. So we're going to go up.
From a plank position, rotate over to a side plank on your left forearm.
And then we're going to lift our leg that's on top while holding ourselves up.
Stay solid and still through your core with your hips stacked right over left. Keep your top leg as straight as possible as you lift it up.
And you don't want to be fast at this. You want this to go slow. Take your time.
Time for side plank leg lifts.
Now we're going to be going to the other side.
30 seconds.
30 seconds, next side.
Now. Switch to a side plank on your right forearm and lift your left leg. Keep your hips stacked left over right with your top leg straight as you raise and lower it.
Keep going.
Try to get a few more.
We got 5 seconds left. Excuse my dog.
Time for lateral bear claw for 50 seconds.
So now we're gonna get on our hands and knees again. We're gonna move to the side, leg up. Then
start
move to the right, leg up.
Knees an inch
back
off the
to
ground
the left.
And under your hips.
And this also helps the hips and the hip flexors.
Move sideways for 3 to 4 steps without crossing your arms or legs, then reverse. You can add or subtract steps.
Excuse my dog in the way.
Available space.
Good boy. All right. Almost done. Good boy.
10 seconds left.
Good boy.
Get ready. All right. Straight leg bicycle.
So now we're gonna do another one. This is more of a stretch. We're gonna lay on our back. We're gonna have our hands interlocked. And this is going to be like a crunch. Put your hands above your head so that your head is resting on the interlocked hands. Go up like you're going for a bicycle and have your right elbow touch your left leg. And then back down. And then have your left elbow touch your right leg. And you want to go a somewhat little bit faster pace than the slower. Lucky! Alright. Almost done. You will feel this. Make sure that when you go back down, you lay flat, and then go back into the other leg. Down, up. Lucky, move.
For 40 seconds.
Alright, so take a break for a few seconds, and then we're gonna go right back into it.
Exhale as you twist towards your opposite leg.
Back into it.
Make your
left elbow touching your right leg down. Right elbow touching your left leg. Left elbow touching right leg. Back down.
And reach elbows to knees.
Make sure that your leg is exactly 90 degree angle when you go up. And then you're going to do the crunch the rest of the way. Up, touch.
10 seconds. Keep going.
10 seconds left.
Get ready for
our
mountain climber for 40
seconds. So now we're going to do the mountain climber, but much faster. So
focus on keeping your core tight and stable.
We're gonna go like this. Switching, rotating the legs. Lucky, if you don't move, little boy.
Go as quickly as you can with good form. Halfway.
Halfway there.
And strong.
You're gonna start to feel it and you're gonna want to stop, but just keep going through the burn.
Up next,
all right,
side plank on your left side.
So this is going to be a little bit more relaxed. We're going to go back into a plank, but instead of being on our elbow,
on your left side with your left hand on the floor,
we're gonna
lift up,
have our
hand, right
hand
on, your
on the floor, and your hand and arm is gonna be what's holding our body weight up.
Halfway there.
Arm above the head, if you would like, or on your hips.
Make sure you keep breathing.
Remember, exhale.
Now moving into high side plank on your right side.
We're gonna go to the next side. Inhale through nose. Exhale
Now,
keep them out.
Working your right side, put your right hand down and your left hand on your hip.
This is a little tricky for me. My carpet is too fuzzy for its own good.
Halfway.
And it is extremely slippy. And I cannot hold my position. Which at first,
you might have trouble with this at first, with this exact stretch. I know I did when I first started playing my academics sports. This was part of our stretching, so at first it will be a little wonky, but it will get easier. So we're gonna go back into it. We're almost done.
Coming up, clamshells with your left leg.
All right.
For 30 seconds.
So now I'm gonna take a few second minute to rehydrate. I'm actually out of shape, so I'm actually sweating up a storm. And from my tracker, activity tracker, I have it set to the different workouts that we're gonna do. Come here. And so right now I have it on set on the core tracker, and it's tracking the time that we're doing this. It'll show the calories I'm burning, my heart rate, how many beats per minute. So if you don't have, lucky, get out of the way. If you don't have a watch, Apple Watch, Samsung Watch, or a Fitbit to track, you can even get a heart rate monitor, and that will track your heart rate. So now we're gonna go back into the workout now that we're more relaxed. But we're just gonna do something relaxing. We're gonna lay on our side, and we're gonna have our arm with our head on it. And our legs are gonna be at a 90 degree angle, and we're gonna lift the leg up. This also is really good if you do with a resistance band.
10 seconds to go.
Resistance bands are actually a good help.
Now moving into clamshells with your
right leg. We're gonna now switch to the other side. Resistance bands are literally what they are, what the word is, resistance. So they give us.
You should be laying on your left
so that
stacking knees and your hips on top of each other.
Help with the power.
Halfway there.
Almost there. Because there's people out there that are supposed
to protect you. Use your right hand if you need it for support and balance.
Keep your leg at a 90 degree angle.
The next drill up is crab reaches.
So now,
for 30 seconds,
we're gonna be like a crab, like we do the crab walk. Right arm up.
Put your heels
left leg
your knees
up.
And your hands
and we're gonna
on your shoulders. Your fingertips should be pointing back towards your feet.
Again, I'm so unbalanced with
halfway
this.
There.
You want to keep your hips up too.
Use the strength of your glutes to lift you up each time. Get ready.
All right,
four stretch on your left leg.
So now we're just gonna stretch. We're gonna have our leg up like we're doing the bicycle. But we're gonna bring up the other leg so that it's resting on the knee right here. And we're gonna pull back. You will feel this stretch pulling in your butt cheek, also the hips. And we're gonna hold. Alright.
Put your left ankle against your right thigh. Lift your right knee and use both hands to pull in towards your chest, stretching the outside of your left leg.
You want to make sure that this leg is flat too, so if you have to push on it a little, that's fine. I have my right hand
holding
sturdy, like right behind the pit of my right leg.
5 seconds left.
We're going to hold it. 5 seconds left.
Up next, figure four stretch on your right leg.
All right.
For 30 seconds.
Same thing. You're going to have your left hand at the pit of your leg.
Now
93 angle.
And rest your right ankle on your left
and leg. Put your left leg. Your left ankle should be touching the top of your knee. If you have to push with your right hand, that is fine.
Your right knee should point out to the side.
And excuse my dog. I have a Rottweiler who is massive in size.
Coming up, quad rockers for 30 seconds.
So now this is easy. On our hands and knees, back, arch.
Go solid and your back flat. Push your tailbone back.
Exactly like this.
Then, forward over your wrist and your hips drop.
Back.
You should feel your hips opening up more and more as you move. 5 seconds.
You want to keep your legs together.
Now moving into kneeling quadricep stretch on your
All right, so now we're going to do this holding lunge. We're going to start with our left leg. Lunge forward.
Kneel with your right foot
and we're going to hold it.
Knee behind. Stay tall as you press your hips forward. Keep pressing forward until you feel a stretch in the front of your left thigh.
Up. And we're gonna hold it. Hands on hips to help with the balance. You want your back to be straight. If you can't hold it for the entire time, just go back up to reposition yourself. Get back down.
Kneeling quadriceps.
Same thing on the next side.
For 30 seconds.
And we're gonna hold.
Kneel with your left foot in front and right knee behind. Keep a tall posture and press your hips forward. Keep pressing forward until you feel a stretch in the front of your right.
You will now feel the lactic acid burning. Like, almost to the point where it really hurts. You want to hold it through. If you have to, go back up. Inhale through your nose, exhale through your mouth.
Time for lying hamstring stretch.
So now,
for 30 seconds.
On our backs, we're just going to have our leg.
Think about making your body as long as possible. Stretch from the top of your head to your extended heels.
Now since we're beginners, we're just gonna go up, hold it down. Make sure your knee is completely straight. I know some of us are not that flexible, so you can't lift it up all the way. Just make sure that it's flat and you can still feel a stretch.
Now moving into lying hamstring stretch.
We're going to do the same thing
for 30 seconds
with our left leg.
Keep your neck and spine flat along the floor as you gently pull your right leg in towards your chest.
As if you do want to hold it, you can put interlock your hands right behind the pit and hold it. You will feel the stretch. Just
breathe,
keep your knee straight.
Through your nose.
Inhale through your nose. Exhale through your mouth.
Time for lower back stretch on your left side for 30 seconds.
Get out of the sink. So now we're going to do the star. We're going to have our left leg. And we're going to bring it to the opposite side.
Body with your right hand.
And we're just going to twist our hip over, not moving our whole entire body.
As you breathe, gently pull your left leg across your body for a deeper stretch.
Mm-hmm. and hold it.
Last one for today.
All right.
Lower back stretch on your right side.
Now we're going to do the same thing with the left, with the right leg, excuse me.
Now, draw your right knee into your chest and pull your right knee across your body with your left hand. Relax your gaze upward or turn and look at your right hand.
All right, so now that concludes the Nike training part. So now you can just relax. You can close out, be done. I've been feeling kind of tight lately. I did the HIIT Zone class on Sunday, and with me being out of shape, I'm sore. So I'm gonna just continue to stretch so that my muscles will loosen up. So I'm gonna do the butterfly. I'm gonna have my feet on the ground like that. And I'm gonna lean in. And I'm gonna hold. Back up. So now I'm gonna do the hurdler. I'm gonna extend my leg out flat and have the other one like my legs are in a four. And I'm gonna pull the toe of my foot back and hold it. Alright, and now I'm gonna switch. If you cannot reach to your toes, do not injure yourself trying to. Just reach the farthest that you can. Alright, so that concludes today's workout video. This was very light, just to start getting your body used to being active. Do not want to go hard right away. Oh jeez. I'm gonna turn that down. So, I'm gonna try to do different workouts from the Nike app, and then also try and do workouts from the Crunch Live workout videos, so that way we can get some other interactive work done. Also, if you're wanting to, you can message me and I'll invite you to the Zumba event that is instructed by the Crunch Fitness Zumba Certified Instructors, which is set for Monday the 23rd at 7. So if you want to join in, let me know and I'll invite you to the event. Go shower, go relax, get rehydrated. And I'll see you tomorrow for our next workout tomorrow.